Is AMD Radeon 7 the best GPU for Hackintosh running macOS Mojave? Are there still problems running it in Hackintosh, or is it already fixed? And how does it perform? So, let's find out! Hi, I'm Teresa from Morgonaut.cloud, and I help people with Hackintosh builds, Macintosh computers, Linux servers, simply with computers. If you are new here, then please click that subscribe button and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. So, AMD Radeon 7 is on the market already for some while. If you are watching some Hackintosh forums, you may know a lot of people were reporting dozens of problems with running Radeon 7 on macOS Mojave, like freezes, mouse stuttering, artifacts, and so on. Those people were looking forward to the latest macOS Mojave 10.14.5 update in hope their Radeon 7 will finally get full support. But even after release of this update, people were still reporting problems. So, where is the truth? Is it running fine or not? I wanted also answers to these questions, so I bought one too. I bought the Sapphire Radeon 7 model, updated my system, installed the card, and let's have a look. I'm running latest macOS Mojave 10.14.5, and About This Mac shows correctly recognized Radeon 7 with 16 gigs of VRAM and system report complete full metal support. So far so good, but let's see how it performs in real-life tasks. Let's say for example 3D rendering. This GPU should have really great OpenCL performance by its pure specifications. Here I prepared a test scene where I can test the Radeon 7 in Maya 3D package and AMD ProRender. IPR render is in full HD resolution. Wow, this is really great! It's really insanely fast! GPU is fully utilized, no glitches, no artifacts, simply running great. UI and render performance is absolutely fantastic. So, let's move on to video editing and test Radeon 7 in Metal Performance instead of OpenCL inside of Blackmagic DaVinci Resolve 15. Here I opened project with my previous video. My timeline and all my source media are in 4K resolution, ProRes 422 HQ, 422 and 10-bit. I have also some H.264 4K footage in my timeline. And my 4K clips have quite a lot of color correction and color grading. As you can see, the timeline performance is amazing. Scrubbing my project is without any limit. Everything is extremely fast. So, let's render it out and see if this Radeon 7 will be fully utilized while final render, or if it will be limited as I saw on some reviews. Bang! As you can see, this card is perfect companion to my Intel Core i9-9900K. Radeon 7 is maxed out and shows its real power. In Luxmark Intensive OpenCL Benchmark, my Radeon 7 scored 50,550 points. That's really very impressive. And I test all my builds on stock settings, so no overclock applied. For example, my Radeon Vega Frontier Edition, with also 16 gigs of VRAM, in this benchmark scores only around 27,000 points. So Radeon 7 is quite 2 times faster. And what about temperatures? Classic GPU sensors for fake SMC will not show temperature for this card. I had to compile newest kernel extensions from source, and now I get the temperature reading. But here, stop for a while. Radeon 7 does not show just one temperature, as for example previous Vega GPUs. It has now also so-called junction temperature, and that's exactly the temperature which shows my hardware monitor. This junction temperature is about 30 to 35 degrees of Celsius higher than the classic GPU temperature. So, as you can see now, while running the Luxmark benchmark, the junction temperature stabilized at maximum 97 degrees of Celsius. So that means my GPU temperature is around 62 up to 67 degrees of Celsius, under maximum load. And I get even higher score than on first run, 50,952 points. I think all these numbers are also very nice surprise. Simply the smaller nanometer technology can be seen here. By the way, EFI folder, which I offer for my 14-core iMac Pro Killer and Vega GPUs, has full support for Radeon 7 and already contains all these latest packages. So feel free to download my EFI if you plan to buy Radeon 7. I cannot talk for other brands of Radeon 7 like XFX or PowerColor. I tested this Sapphire version, and because I recommend strictly only components I tested and verified personally, I can recommend this Sapphire one. Link to my exact tested model you can find now in this video description. I ran this Radeon 7 for a month already, and I haven't seen a single problem with it. In all applications and also system-wide, it is simply running perfectly. I ran three 24-inch displays out of three display ports on the back of the card. There is also HDMI port on this card, which is also running fine. The only issue, which is not related to Hackintosh, I found is, when I reboot now my computer, after reboot only two of three displays will be showing picture. I would need to disconnect the DisplayPort cable and connect back to see the picture also on the third display. But when I boot this Hackintosh from the shutdown state, all three displays will come up fine. I said this is not related to Hackintosh, because absolutely same behavior I noticed when testing this card under latest Windows 10. Probably something in VBIOS is still waiting for fix. By the way, when speaking about VBIOS, Radeon 7 was originally shipped with VBIOS, which was causing a lot of issues. Few weeks ago, AMD released the 106 update, so check what version of VBIOS is your card running. The old VBIOS is identified as 016. Dot blah blah, simply like this. The new one after update is like this. So, conclusion. Can I now, after really heavy testing, recommend this card to Hackintosh users? My answer is absolutely! And not to just Hackintosh users, also to Mac users, because this card will easily outperform any GPU which Apple currently offers even in their high-end iMac Pros. I think this is now my number one choice for any Hackintosh where you really need ultimate performance. 3D artists or video editors will be totally happy with Radeon 7. I think for next few years, this amazing GPU will always have its place in my Hackintosh. So, I hope I made your day again a little better. If so, please click on the like button below. Click also the share button so more people can benefit from it. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you won't miss any of my future videos. And if you would need some help with your computer, you can always get my personal support on my Patreon or Subscribestar. Links are now in this video description. You can also reach me at my Facebook, Twitter, Reddit or my website. Links are again now in this video description. Morgonaut is always here to help. So, that's all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time, my Hackintosh friends.